An Australian climate change advocate has addressed the first United Nations water conference in 46 years. Mina Guli didn't get there the easy way. She ran to New York City to raise awareness and focus attention on the world's water crisis. Starting at Uluru, she completed 200 marathons in 365 days, covering almost 8,500 kilometres. And joining us now all the way from New York is Mina Guli. I can't believe, Mina, that you say you're not actually a runner, but you've completed 200 marathons. Incredible. How hard was it?
Let's go with very hard. I mean, to be honest, it's absolutely the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. Not surprisingly, it's 200 marathons. One marathon is hard, let alone like 200 of these things, particularly because I didn't choose the easiest places to run. I ran up in glaciers and down rivers and through rainforests and mud and snow and ice. So, you know, I could have probably made it a lot easier for myself, but one of the reasons why I wanted to do this was to show the power of all of us to do two things. The first is to set these big, bold, audacious goals, things that we never thought we could possibly achieve, and then just go out and do them. And the second one is because I wanted to show that we can do hard things, that it doesn't matter whether it's running 200 marathons or solving the global water crisis, we're capable of doing so much more than we think.
Just on the run, you must have had some really tough days. What were some of the hardest moments you were up against?
I found the running really hard, but that's probably an obvious statement. As I said, a lot of the places I chose to run were physically challenging, either at altitude or literally running through desert sands, or a couple of times we had some flash floods and I was running through water literally up to my waist. So those were physically challenging. But I think the biggest challenge was the emotional challenge of having to deal with the water crisis and its consequences every single day, meeting people all day, every day that were suffering from these problems. And I wanted to lift up the voices of these people that were impacted. The consequence, of course, is that as you're going out there, I'm walking my distance, you know, alongside women and girls who literally walk hours every day risking their lives to go fetch water for their families. I'm meeting farmers who are struggling to grow their crops because they're dealing with issues of no water, or people watching their lakes and rivers dry up before their eyes. You know, seeing this every day and realising the impact of our actions on our global water table and the importance of having and needing that, I think that was the hardest.
You chose the places you went quite specifically, and I'm intrigued by the fact that you, early on, you ran in Menindee, which had that fish kill how many years ago, and then recently we saw it again. How did you feel when you saw that reprise?
So I think that one of the biggest challenges that we have is the damage that we're doing to our ecosystem and our environment. It's easy when we live in big cities to think that water comes out of a tap, but water doesn't come from a tap. Water comes from healthy ecosystems. We need these things to be alive and healthy. And when we see the impact of fish kills, let's face it, not only in Menindee, but fish kills have been happening all across the world. They are one of the first signs that our ecosystem is unhealthy and unhappy. We need to pay attention to it, and we need to take action to solve it.
You spoke during the UN Water Conference last week. You must have been exhausted, by the way, after the run. But why are you so passionate about water?
Because water goes into everything we use, we buy and we consume every single day, from the food we eat to the clothes that we wear to the power that went into the screens we're talking to each other on right now. All of those things take water to make. You know, just as an example, the water that goes into just those outfits that you guys are wearing tonight, very smart, by the way, took more water to make than all the water you drank before you were 40 years old. Just like each one of those outfits.
Wow.
The numbers are crazy. And we're just totally ignoring them. So water isn't just an environmental issue. It's also a social and an economic issue, and it's an all of us issue. Water is everything, and for too long we've treated it as if it's nothing. And to be honest, that needs to change. It needs to change now.
Now, Mina, you've run over 200 marathons. I signed up 3 months ago for my first ever marathon. It was 10 months out. Since then I've Googled, can you run a marathon with 9 months' practice? Can you run a marathon with 8 months' practice? I'm now down to 7. When will I have to start to be able to pull this marathon off?
If you're strong in heart and strong in mind, the day before.
I think I might push it to next year.
No way! No way! No excuses! It's not even the comedy gold. It's just like, don't be a wuss bag. Just get out there and do it.
There we go. Well, now it's there, isn't it?
Don't be a wuss bag,
don't
mate.
Don't be a wuss bag.
I love it.
Mate, I can run 200 marathons. At least you can do is one. OK, bye.
She's gone.
So did she want me to run one or not?
I think you offended her. She left so quickly, Nick.
That's the first guest ever to hang up on us, isn't
it? Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Normally we hang up on them. But Nick Cody, you've made a powerful enemy.
Well, I think I'm free. I don't have to run a marathon.
No, 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 no. Well, I want to watch this.